You gotta be passionate and really like what you do. And when I get up to go to work in the morning, I look forward to solving whatever problems come up that day. Some of the obstacles that we run into throughout the year, water is a huge issue. This drought is very dire. We're lucky that in the area that I farm, we're okay this year. But I've got friends and I know of farmers over in other parts of the state who absolutely got zero water, and they're looking for every single drop that they can just to keep their crops alive, to be able to survive just to the next year and not lose their entire farming operation.
This site is one of three sites. There's one in Tehama County and one down near Bakersfield with the same experimental protocol and the same objective. Try to quantify the relationship between how much water you put on the trees and how much yield you get off of the trees, both in the short term and in the long term. So if we can improve the water management of almond growers, this would make a big difference in the amount of water we have for use in the state for other purposes besides agriculture, if it turns out that they can use less water.
We tend to focus a lot on water, especially in a time of drought, but in every aspect of a lot of these perennial nut crop industries, including almonds, the University of California and research conducted by its faculty and advisors have touched just about every process, from propagating trees, to growing trees, to fertilizing trees, to harvesting trees, and actually processing those in the post-harvest end as well. And is the main reason why we are the number one producer, least yield per acre, in those tree nut crops compared to any country across the world.